Guys, it's summer in Holland. Yay, look at this beautiful weather. It's so crappy and these children are so loud. It's so annoying, but let's get right into the video. Greatest people, welcome to a new video. This video is about my insane story of Vietnam.
Vietnam!
Last year, 2015, me and my friends went for 3 weeks to Vietnam. We went all the way from south to north. That was our plan, as you can see in the picture, from Ho Chi Minh to Hanoi. That was our goal. And we were gonna do it in 3 weeks. Our first plan was to go with the train. Then after that we said, well, okay, let's just go to the middle with the airplane. And then at some point, there were these two Dutch guys in front of our hostels with motorcycles, with scooters. And I already saw my friends looking at it like, oh shit, we wanna do that as well. Fuck you, scooter. And I was like, no, I don't wanna do it because I never drove a motorcycle before. I never rode a scooter before. And if I'm gonna start in Vietnam, in Ho Chi Minh as well, it's just fucking stupid. But at some point, I saw how enthusiastic my friends were, and I was like, I'm only one time, only in Vietnam. So I was like really struggling with myself. What am I gonna do? I don't know. And at some point I was like, okay, fuck it. I called a YOLO. I hate using that word, but this was really like a YOLO. I was like, just fuck it, do it. This was probably the most unresponsible idea I ever did. I started off in Ho Chi Minh City. As you can see in the video right now, it's insane. There are scooters fucking everywhere. Everywhere where you go, they're all honking and just riding, and it's just super crazy, super crazy. But I still managed to get out of the city somehow. I was very lucky that I made it out alive. Anyway, it was day one. The second day, I was very excited to get up my cycle again, my scooter, and we were off. We were driving up a mountain. It's okay, nothing. Yeah, it was just normal. But at some point, you kind of get bored, so you kind of look around you, just what's happening. And I was just driving, and so I was looking at the thingies, and I saw like, ooh, my front wheel shouldn't go inside the berm, because that will totally screw me up. But yeah, you go where you look. So I went like this and this and this, and then booyah! Yeah, was like booyah! And I fell in the thing. My front wheel went in it, and automatically you grab your hand because you wanna keep yourself. So I was grabbing the fangadil, and of course you cut it, cut my hand. Like I got off my scooter and I was like, oh, what the hell. And okay, I'm okay, I can still walk. Okay, so I look at the ground and there were all like this drops of blood on the ground. They were like, what the fuck, where does that come from? So I was looking at my body and I'm like, huh? And then at some point, yeah, it was my hands. And especially here, it was cut open and oh, it was so bad. And also here, my friend was driving behind me, so he started like, here, what the fuck happened, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, I don't know, and this and this. And we didn't have any disinfection stuff with us. So he got this napkin, special napkin to clean stuff up. It's called Allesreiniger. And he said, well, it's not meant to make your wounds clean, but we have nothing else, so you better just use it. So I cleaned my wounds with something that isn't supposed to make it cleaner. But oh, and my hand was still very bleeding, but luckily I just had a course, so I knew, oh, if you're bleeding, you have to put the bleed above your heart, then yeah, it won't bleed as much. So I was standing next to the highway like this, and all the Vietnamese people that were coming by, they were like, what's going on? Why are you pulling, why do you have your hand up? And I'm like, it's okay, just continue, it's okay. And it was such a drama. But eventually I still got up on the motorbike and I just went. And the first hotel that we saw, we stopped there. And in the evening, my feet really started to hurt, like I could not walk hardly. Do you want to take x-rays? And I was like, well, maybe it's a good thing to do because I'm just gonna ignore it. And maybe if it is broken or whatever, then I might be just totally screwed. So we took x-rays, which I actually got here. I'm not sure if you can see it. Yeah, these are my x-rays. These were my feet. These were my hands, because my hands also hurt, I couldn't do anything. But in the end, it was pretty logical, because my hand also had like a very big bang on it. There was nothing wrong with it. So we went back to the hotel, we started sleeping. And the next day, I didn't really feel like biking anymore, but I was like, fucking hey, what are we gonna do? The next destination. And you know, the worst thing was, because my hands were here, like totally open, and it couldn't heal properly, because every time I have to gear, of course you put pyro on it and it gets open again, and the roads are so dusty, so all sand comes in. And I was like, okay, it's really gonna infect now, it's not okay, fuck. In Hoi An, which is like the middle of Vietnam, I decided, okay guys, I'm done, I'm completely done, I don't wanna go anymore, I'm just done. So my friends continued and I was left behind. So I had to find my own journey, and I still had to sell it. So I realized I should make like an advertisement. So I made this. This cool plate, which I just put on my head. And I was just walking like, with this sign over me. And everyone was laughing at me, and other Vietnamese people were coming to me like, oh, what's this? But it still didn't work out. So I was like, okay, fuck it. I just went to a garage and I said to them, buy my bike, please. And they said, okay, yeah, $60. I'm like, what? Because I paid $300 for it. But I was so dumb with the whole scooter thing. I was like, whatever, just buy it. I don't want to be done with it. So I got $60 only. If I think about it back, like, for me, it was so irresponsible to just go cycle, and I even though I didn't have like zero experience with driving a scooter, a motorcycle, whatever. And I'm very blessed that it turned out fine. Like, seriously, it could have been so much worse. Well, this was my crazy Vietnam story. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please be responsible when you travel. Don't do crazy shit. Or you can do crazy shit, but not too crazy. I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Chet, and I will see you on the flip side. Oh, fucking right! Yeah! Okay, doe normaal. Yay, Vessa, regen, hoi.